You're watching ABC News at 10 with your Alaska Link News Team. Lindsay Houseman, Ryan Overton with your forecast, and John Thompson with sports.
Iditarod rookie trading the sea for snow was an easy decision. Monica Zappa is tackling her first Iditarod and using the last great race as a platform to save our salmon. Jessica Grueling has more.
Monica Zappa is no stranger to mushing. She is a second generation musher who says it was in her blood from day one.
My first memories were with dogs and it was really in my blood, and I went through my life till I was a teenager, really, really close to the dogs. And then my dad passed away, and we weren't able to keep the dogs, my mom and I. And so I kind of unfortunately drifted away from that and didn't have any dogs for about 14 years of my life, and I really missed it a lot.
4 years ago, Zappa traded in the Cheese State for the last frontier. Little did she know, she would be hitting the only trail to run from Anchorage into Nome.
I wasn't sure if I was going to even do any races. That wasn't my intention at all. I just wanted to come up here and see if I liked it and see if I, you know, liked the dogs. And it turns out I really loved them and couldn't live without them. And they really suck you in. And these guys are totally my family now.
This is her first 1,000-mile journey across some of Alaska's roughest terrain.
I'm feeling, everything you possibly can be feeling. Really excited, a little bit nervous. All the preparation and anticipation is way more massive than I ever expected. You know, I've been thinking about the trail and how that's all going to go, and there's a lot of solitude in that part of it, and I've really been wrapping my head around that.
Zappa isn't just taking on the trail for herself. She's mushing to save Bristol Bay.
The dogs love salmon. It's their favorite food, and so we just want to make sure that we can protect, like, you know, the number one resource, renewable resource in Alaska, also, like, the number one healthy, amazing, protein-rich food source for our huskies and ourselves. And if it wasn't for salmon, I mean, mushing wouldn't be the same. And I don't think that there's a lot of people that realize that connection. And not only that, but there's a lot of mushers that are commercial fishermen too.
When she's not racing or practicing for the Iditarod, Zappa is a commercial fisherman, which could explain why she's on a quest to keep Alaska's natural resource alive. As a part of her mission, Zappa has prepared packets to send to children in villages along the route in a very traditional way.
Keeping with the Alaskan tradition of, you know, when they carried mail by dog sled from Anchorage to Nome, and so I'm carrying a message to the villages.
Even as a newbie, her team is solid. She says some of her best guidance comes from her partner, Tim Osmer. He is an ultimate veteran with 23 races under his belt.
Of course, he keeps saying when I ask him questions like, oh, what should I do here? What should I do here? He's like, oh, I don't remember. It's been so long. He hasn't run the race for 5 years, which to him is an eternity after he spent, you know, half his life on the, you know, running the race.
This rookie has more than just a first run to worry about.
I'm a bit worried about the trail because this year, as you know, our snow conditions are much less than we would desire as Iditarod mushers.
On her journey through the backcountry of the last frontier, Zappa's mission isn't to win. This year, she just wants to enjoy the trail and hopefully inform others about saving our salmon. In Anchorage, Jessica Grunling, your Alaska Link.
Of course, all things Iditarod you can get updates on starting here on ABC Monday with John Thompson.